My name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this tutorial, we're going to talk about the reaction of Alka-Seltzer if we simply plop it in water. There are three main active ingredients in Alka-Seltzer. The first one is aspirin. This is an organic compound, and while it does have tremendous benefits in having it included in Alka-Seltzer as a medicine, it contributes very little to a chemical reaction because, for one, it is not soluble in water. The second ingredient is sodium bicarbonate, otherwise known as baking soda. This is a somewhat basic compound, and as such, it will help neutralize stomach acid. The third ingredient is citric acid, and as the name implies, it is an acid. In water, it will react with the sodium bicarbonate, and it will produce carbon dioxide gas, and that will help ease any kind of bloating or trapped gas in the body as it is taken. But when it comes to experiments with Alka-Seltzer, the two components that we need to be mindful of are the sodium bicarbonate and the citric acid. The chemical equation that describes the reaction between the two will have to consider both the acidic parts of citric acid and the base nature of sodium bicarbonate. So when we have this task of writing a chemical equation, the first thing is to know what is the formula of the two compounds. The sodium bicarbonate is the easier one of the two. This is soluble in water, and when the Alka-Seltzer tablet is dropped in water, it will dissolve fairly instantly. The second ingredient is citric acid, and this will be soluble in water because of the many OH groups that there are, but specifically the carboxylic acid groups that are on there. Another way to write the formula of citric acid to illustrate all of its components is this. We have a carbon here that has two CH2 groups attached to it. These are CH2, and these are CH2 groups. Those hydrogens will not participate in any chemical equation. There is also an OH group attached to that carbon in the center. And from there, we have three carboxylic acid groups. We have this one at the top, which says there is a carbon with a doubly bound oxygen and an OH group. There is this carbon with a doubly bound oxygen and an OH group. And finally, we have this carbon with a doubly bound oxygen and an OH group. The carboxylic acid groups are going to release hydrogen in water, and when that hydrogen reacts with a base, then more of those hydrogens will be released. This is also an aqueous solution. When the hydrogens are released from the carboxylic acid groups, then there is an opportunity for carboxylates to form. And in those instances, the sodium is going to take the place of the hydrogen. So we write the same structure but now we will retain the carbon that is doubly bound to the oxygen, and we are simply going to remove the hydrogen that is attached to that oxygen. In this case, the oxygen will acquire a negative charge because the sodium has a positive charge, and it will happen the same way for all three of them. What is left is hydrogen combining with the bicarbonate ion, which produces carbonic acid. And carbonic acid is incredibly unstable, easily decomposes to produce water in the liquid form and carbon dioxide in the gas phase. It is not a balanced chemical equation just yet. Because we have three carboxylic acid groups on citric acid, that means we will need 3 moles of sodium bicarbonate to react with each 1 mole of citric acid. So we place a 3 in front of the sodium bicarbonate. On the product side then, we will need to produce 3 moles of water and 3 moles of carbon dioxide. And now we have a balanced molecular equation for the reaction of sodium bicarbonate and citric acid. Once we have a chemical equation, we can move ahead and calculate all manner of problems. One of the more straightforward things about working with Alka-Seltzer tablets in water is that one of the products is carbon dioxide that is a gas with low solubility in water, and that gas can be driven off in a relatively straightforward manner. If we don't put in the effort to capture the carbon dioxide amount and weight as such, we can assume to have a good estimate for the amount of carbon dioxide released by looking at how much did the mass of reactant versus mass of the products change, because the only thing that should have gone away was the carbon dioxide. By this difference in mass of what went in and mass of what came out, we can find how much carbon dioxide was created. And that's what we're going to start with here. We have 0.50 grams of carbon dioxide, and in our first attempt, we will calculate how much sodium carbonate was consumed. So we start with 0.50 grams of carbon dioxide. And in the first step, we convert to moles so we may access the ratios of the chemical equation. Each 1 mole of carbon dioxide weighs 44.01 grams of carbon dioxide. Then we go from moles of carbon dioxide to moles of sodium bicarbonate. In the previous equation, we have a 3-to-3 ratio. For each 3 moles of sodium bicarbonate consumed, we produced 3 moles of carbon dioxide. And from there, we convert to grams of sodium bicarbonate because the problem is asking for mass and not moles. Each 1 mole of sodium bicarbonate weighs 84.007 grams of sodium bicarbonate. The grams of carbon dioxide, the moles of carbon dioxide, and the moles of sodium bicarbonate will cancel, giving us our final value in grams of sodium bicarbonate, and that will be 0.954 grams of sodium bicarbonate. If we consume this much sodium bicarbonate, then 0.5 grams of carbon dioxide will be produced. The other part of this calculation implies that we're also consuming the citric acid. And because we are putting the Alka-Seltzer tablet in water, the only acid available for the sodium bicarbonate to react with is the citric acid. So we can make that assumption that there is enough acid to produce the 0.50 grams of carbon dioxide. So let's turn this around. Start with the mass of carbon dioxide, 0.50 grams of carbon dioxide. Convert it first into moles. 1 mole of carbon dioxide weighs 44.01 grams of carbon dioxide. Then we convert from moles of carbon dioxide to moles of citric acid. And I'm just going to shorthand the citric acid with a CA. According to our balanced chemical equation, every time 1 mole of citric acid is consumed, it produces 3 moles of carbon dioxide. And from there, we convert our moles of citric acid to grams. The molar mass of citric acid is 192.124 grams of citric acid. This allows us to cancel the grams of carbon dioxide, the moles of carbon dioxide, and the moles of citric acid, giving us our final value in grams of citric acid. This will be 0.728 grams of citric acid. So from these two calculations, we can tell that every time 0.728 grams of citric acid is combined with our previously calculated 0.954 grams of sodium bicarbonate, the result is going to be the production of 0.5 grams of carbon dioxide. However, if we have either excess of sodium bicarbonate or excess of citric acid, then the leftover acid or base is going to remain in the solution because they are soluble even though they didn't react. So how can we tell which one is in excess? Is there more citric acid or is there more sodium bicarbonate in an Alka-Seltzer tablet? An easy approach to this would be to simply use a pH probe or a pH paper that will help us determine if the resulting solution is more acidic or more basic. If the solution is more basic, then we should have an excess of sodium bicarbonate. If it is basic, we should have an excess of citric acid.